world.
I may have to cover that myself.
But wait, it's true. Jesus was the dividing point in world history, B.C., before Christ.
And A.D., we're living in the time of our Lord.
Aren't they cute? Come on, kids. Christmas is just a holiday. It didn't change all of history, so happy holidays. This is Rachel Starr with What's New at Noon, and that's the news.
And cut, that's a wrap.
Oh, how did I look?
Walking, walking, walking in the light.
Christmas, why the rejoicing was so prominent in that original Christmas and why many are rejoicing tonight is because Jesus came not just to be born in a manger, not just to live a good life and to be a good teacher. He came to pay the price for the sin of all mankind. And that means your sin tonight. My sin. It's easy to say, well, everybody's a sinner all around us. Yes, but I am. You are. And the reality is we must have a Savior. We cannot save ourselves. We cannot perform to somehow earn our way into heaven or do religious calisthenics so that, you know, God will somehow be pleased and we can squeak into the door of heaven. There's no chance on our own. The only chance we have is that someone was our substitute, our Savior, and that, oh, that is Jesus Christ tonight. And Jesus said it this way, unless you become like a little child, you won't enter the kingdom of heaven. But if you have faith like a child, you know what? Jesus can forgive you. Jesus can step into your heart and make a difference and change and forgive and wash away the sin, the things that you're ashamed of tonight. Jesus knows what those are and He paid the price for them. And the best Christmas present, really the reason for Christmas, is that we must have a Savior. We must be forgiven. And tonight, very simply, we want to give you an opportunity to receive that this evening and to receive Jesus Christ into your heart to be your Lord and your Savior. Tonight you can have forgiveness. You can be washed clean from your sin and leave this place a brand new person by the power of the living.